guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited to be back here today. My name is Mona. For those of you who are new here, I missed you guys. How have you guys been? I have been wanting to do this video for the longest time. I'm so excited to be doing this video finally today. I've just been dealing with life, doing the most, living. But I'm so excited to be back here today with this video. I have been wanting to do it for the longest time. I'm going to be doing my stay at home slay slash what's in my quarantine makeup bag. Here it is. Ooh, I'm so excited. So I'm just really going to be sharing with you guys what products have been working for me during this period, what products I'm excited about. Some of these products I only started using them during this period, and then others I've always been using. Their all-time faves, you guys know them, you'll be seeing them. Anyways, I'm going to be doing a cute little stay at home quarantine slay makeup tutorial. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, guys, please do subscribe and stay tuned and see how I create this look. Okay, so I've already moisturized my face and I use the Olay Solar Sheer Day Cream. I use the one that's normal to oily because I have oily skin and it's very lightweight. That's why I love it a lot. Plus it has SPF 15, that is sunscreen. I love to use a moisturizer that also doubles as a sunscreen because I'm very lazy when it comes to applying products and I want to use products that are easy to use. Like I just wake up and put one thing on and go, which some people may cringe if they hear this. I really need to up my skincare routine game. That's why I think I've probably not even done a skincare video yet, because I don't feel like I use a lot of stuff, and that is all I use, guys. I only do that Olay in the morning after showering and I'm good to go. So I'm now going to prime my skin and I'm going to be using the Smashbox Photo Finish Smooth and Blur Primer. This is a product that I recently got, guys, that I love. If you have oily skin, if you have pores that you want to just like smoothen, blur, what, it really is photo finish. I love this primer. I've been seeing so many like YouTubers, people raving about this, and I was just like, I need to get that product. And finally I have it and I get to use it, and this is actually a new one. I'm so excited, guys. And I also have this available if you need it. I always like to use products in my tutorials that I already have that I can actually sell to you guys, because I know the struggle in town. I always say this in all my videos, so I always want to have something that I'm using, and if you guys are like, "Ooh, I want that," it's available, I can get it for you. So if you want this primer, hit me up on Instagram. Do you guys follow me on Instagram? If you do, drop a heart in the comment section below. Yeah, so I'm going to put this on my skin. I'm putting just a little bit. This one is a bit watery. Ooh, oh my god, it feels smooth, like literally, like I cannot even feel any like rash or anything on my face. Like it really is like a smooth and blur primer. What, I don't even know how to explain, guys. It feels so good. Ooh. So anyways, guys, how have you been? What have you been doing during this period to keep you guys busy? We're all under lockdown, which sucks. I really don't know when this is going to end, but I know it's going to end one day, hopefully soon. Yeah, I can't wait to go back to work, to beat people's faces, to actually just be in the studio. I miss my studio so much. Anyways, so I'm done applying the primer. I love it. It feels so amazing, guys. I'm now going to go in with my foundation, and for that I'm going to be using the Estee Lauder Fluid Makeup Foundation. This is a product that I also, guys, these are two products that I've discovered during quarantine, the primer and the Estee Lauder. The Olay is my everyday holy grail. Yeah, but this Estee Lauder, I love, 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 love. Guys, it has a very, very, like, it's very lightweight, and it doesn't give you a lot of coverage. Okay, it gives you just enough coverage, not too much. It doesn't feel heavy. It doesn't feel like I've just, like, you know, like, put, like, a ton of makeup on. I love how it goes on so light. Yeah, so it's a product that I just really started using during this period. As you know, I'm always using my Black Opal, but I started using this Estee Lauder, blending the foundation onto my skin. Guys, look at that coverage. It is so bomb. Love it, love it, love it. So today I'm also kind of rushing through my makeup. I have a live an Instagram live to do in less than an hour, and I'm just like, whoa, I need to be done filming then. And I didn't want to just do my makeup and then not film, because then that to me feels like wasted makeup. Every time I do makeup, I have to film, take a good picture. Yeah, seeing as we're not going anywhere for anyone to see the face bit. Done blending the foundation over my skin. As you guys can see, it looks flawless. I don't have this foundation for sale, but I know you can get it from Linton's Beauty World, because that's where I got it. I love it. Such a fire product. And I'm now going to highlight under my eyes. I'm going to be using the Black Opal Stick Concealer, and I'm just using my ring finger to apply that. I usually like to rub with my finger just to like warm up the product, and then I can just apply that under my eyes. I don't like to put a lot of product when I'm staying at home. I don't like to put a lot of product on the skin. That's why I'm into that other foundation. It's super light. And also, I feel like when I apply with my hand, it just goes on lightly, and I get to put it exactly where I need it to be. So just gonna apply there, a little bit on the center part of my forehead, and the bridge of my nose, just to highlight. And I'm using my beauty blender to blend that out. I'm now going to set my foundation using my all-time favorite invisible oil blocking Black Opal powder. I love this powder. If you have oily skin, this is great. I talk about this powder all the time, and it works for like all skin tones, literally. Okay, unless if you're like really light, but like dark people, this is the foundation I'd recommend. Anyone my skin tone or even darker, this powder is perfect for you. And it's very lightweight. I also use my beauty blender as well to apply that. I also have these beauty blenders available. If you need it, just send me a DM on Instagram and I can have it delivered to you. So I'm putting this powder on all the places that I would normally highlight. So this is like a quick, subtle bit. I don't know if it's subtle for everyone, subtle for me. And I'm going to get my powder brush from this brush set. I show it to you guys all the time, but it's because it has it has everything that you need. It's a 24-piece brush set. I have it available if you need.
So I've gotten the powder brush, and I'm going to just dust off the excess powder. Dusting. This is more like a get ready with me. I really am actually getting ready to go for this live video, and why not show you how I'm slaying during quarantine.
So I'm now going to go in with a Black Opal translucent powder in the shade Deep. You know I use this powder all the time. This is also an all-time fave. It's like my go-to powder. Yeah. So as you can see, I'm mixing some new products, some old products. There's some products that you just can't get rid of. Even when you get new products, you still go back to your everyday, like how I go back to my Black Opal always. I've opened a new one. I just love how it looks, guys. It has a bit of a shimmer. It looks fire. It's bronzy. It just gives the face warmth. Oh, it's so perfect. So I use this to contour. So I'm going to use that under my cheekbones, over my forehead. Do you already see the warmth it's creating, guys? Can you see it, or is it just me? Like, literally, whatever makeup bag I'm holding, wherever I'm going, I always have these two powders in my makeup bag. Always. Like, I just cannot do without them. If you're like melanin queen, you need to get onto this product. Black Beauty. This product was made for you. You'd think I'm the one who makes the product, or they're paying me, guys. It's not a sponsored video by Black Opal. I wish it was, though. They need to hit me up, those guys. Like, for real, for real. Love, 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 love this finish. I love that it's very lightweight. It doesn't feel heavy. It's perfect. I've gotten a smaller brush, and I'm just going to give my nose like a slight contour. So usually when I'm contouring my nose, I like to start like my eyebrows and go down the nose, the bridge of the nose, like that, Just slightly, not too much. Now going to set my face and guess what? Drum roll, guys. So excited to be using this product. Finally, I have been looking forward to getting this What It Do Fenty Beauty Mist Refreshing Spray. It smells like heaven. I don't even know what that smells like, but like, it smells amazing. I love it. I love, love, love. I also love the applicator. Like, it doesn't bring out too much. Like, it doesn't make your makeup wet. Like, you can spray a lot and it just goes on perfectly. Oh my god, you guys need to get into this product. I am shook. Anyways, so that is a quarantine fave, a new one. Yeah, a new quarantine fave. Brushing out my eyebrows quickly, I am going to highlight underneath and then fill them in. So I'm still going to be using my concealer, my Black Opal concealer. I'm hitting a bit on my brush and I'm just going to highlight. You guys know how I do my eyebrows. There's a tutorial down here for you. My current eyebrow routine, just go check it out. There's a link in my in the description box. Check it out and let me know what you think. Done filling in my eyebrows, I'm going to do my eyes now. And for eyes, I'm going to be using the Huda Beauty Nude Obsessions palette. So I'm going to be using this palette. I still don't know what look I'm going to do, but I'm going to figure it out. I love the colors. There's like a cream brown color over there in the corner. I'm going to use this for the transition shade. To go in with this, I think, let me go in with a maroon shade, and I'm using this in the crease, just blending back and forth. I'm going to use the darkest shade, the brown, in the corner over there, and I'm just dabbing that on the outer corner of my crease to give me depth, to actually give my eyes depth. I don't know if I should use this entirely. I'm so tempted to just use this shade all over my lid. I've actually started packing it on. Going back in with the brown just to blend. I kind of want to have like a nudie, like brown smoky eye. So let me just go in a little more with a darker shade, with a brown, just to create more depth, more smoke. I'm actually feeling this color so much. It's like a chocolate brown. I've gotten a more precise eyeshadow brush and I'm going to use this on the brown, the coffee brown chocolate. I don't know what shade it is. And I'm using that on my lower lash line to give my eyes some depth. Ooh, guys, look at that smoke. Love it. I live for a smoky eye. I genuinely feel like that's what suits my eyes best. I mean, if you have hooded eyes, the best thing to do for your eyes is just to smoky eyes. So I've gotten a precise eyeshadow brush and I'm going in with that shimmer, the one that cracked, and yet it's the prettiest. It sucks. I'm using that on the inner corner of my eyes just to highlight just a bit. So pretty. So I don't want to do eyeliner. I'm just lazy. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my angled brush, the one I use to do my eyebrows, and I'm going to get this brown shade and I'm going to use that as my eyeliner. I'm just going to pack it onto my lash line, upper lash line, like that. I'm packing it on like as though I was putting on eyeliner. Do you see that? Can you even see? I don't know if you guys can see. Guys, I use my phone to film these tutorials. You have to use what you have. Yeah, so it's not like a camera where I can easily zoom in and like show you guys the smallest detail. But we'll get there one day. So for mascara, guys, I'm going to be using my all-time fave, Black Opal Volumizing Mascara. Yeah, this is an all-time fave. I use this all the time, every day. I've been loving it since before quarantine, and I'm still going to be loving it even after. Guys, I just love Black Opal. I love the brand. They have really good products, and they're really affordable. And they are made specifically for us. We're almost done. I'm now going to highlight my face, and for that I'm going to be using my all-time fave, the Black Opal Illuminating Highlight Stick. Yeah, so Black Opal Illuminating Highlighting Stick. I use this all the time because of that. Yeah, because of what it does. It's so pretty. I love how it just gives me like a very nice dewy, very natural glow. Like I don't even have to try so hard. Then I also like to put a bit on my forehead because like the angle. Done highlighting. This is why it's my all-time fave, because it's so pretty. Going in with blush, I'm using the Blush Me Up Blacker palette. Packing that onto my cheekbones. So the blush goes right in between my contour and my highlight. Pretty girl. Guys, I really do have a lot of fun doing my makeup. I psych myself up. I'm like, look at how, who's she, where's she going? Home, living room, bedroom. Yeah. Not too much.
Now guys, it's time for the final product. My favorite, Fenty Beauty Gloss Bomb.
Love it. I don't know how much to tell you guys how I love this product, but look at, I literally don't know what to do with myself. Like, what is the meaning of this? What? We are finally done. Here is my stay at home slay makeup look. Very easy to do, very pretty, very glowy, very nice. I've been enjoying these makeup products so much. Some of them I only recently started using, and I'm in love with them. So here it is. Let me know what you think. I hope you guys enjoyed this makeup tutorial, and if you have, feel free to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, guys, if you haven't, and yeah, enjoy. Stay at home, stay safe, stay positive, stay slaying. Recreate this look, tag me. I love you guys. See you next time. Bye.